If you want to hold an audience's attention, kill somebody in the first 7 minutes. Show death, loved ones suffering, sadness, fear, and grief. Show a lot of grief. Now the audience knows you're not just monkeying around. Now they'll take your movie seriously. We're not going to do that. We're going to try to hold your attention with an honest mystery, a mystery that's so real we don't need death. We can bring out Chekhov's gun and not ever have to fire it, not ever. We've got a great detective, Tim Jennison, a video designer, an inventor who has dedicated years of his life to this mystery. You'll be the jury and you'll decide. Back in 1651, was there in Old Delft, Holland, a secret so secret that until now, nobody even knew it was a secret? And was it all done with mirrors? My name is Penn Jillette. This is my partner, Teller. We are Penn and Teller. And this is the mystery of Vermeer's Edge.
So I was looking at the Vermeer painting, The Soldier and the Laughing Girl. The soldier is on the left, the laughing girl is on the right. There's an open window. I looked at that shape in the reflection on the open window, and to me it looks like an arch. So I came all the way here to Old Delft, and I looked for something like that. Here is the site of Mechelen, Vermeer's father's tavern, where Vermeer painted his early paintings. If it was painted here, Vermeer would have been directly above this spot on the next floor. There would be a window here and a window there. The soldier is here, the laughing girl is here, and the open window would be right about here. So I held up my phone to see what the reflection in the window would be. I pull it out to about the right angle. I'm looking for something that looks like an arch. And there it is. It's that arch on the front of the steeple of the new church. What this means is that Vermeer probably was painting exactly what he saw, and that's what he saw. And when I saw that arch in the front of my phone, I felt like Indiana Jones in that scene where he plants the diamond and the sunlight hits and it bounces off, and suddenly he knows where the lost ark is.
Queen Elizabeth owns the music lesson. She owns it herself. It's hers. She can take it wherever she wants. She'd go over your house. Hey, how you doing? Here's my painting. Let's put it up on the wall. She can do whatever she wants. So we called up the Queen to ask if we could shoot some video of her little painting. Well, when I say we called up the Queen, I mean that our producer, Ms. Farley Ziegler in L.A., called up who? Lady-in-waiting? Elf? Knight? Who answers the phone for the Queen? And Sir Elf Lady-in-Waiting said that Her Royal Holiness Majesty Matriarch Queen Mum only let the peasants, who incidentally paid for the painting, see the painting during the summer when the Queen is on vacation. Vacation from what? She's the Queen! What does she do? Fly to Disney World and taunt Cinderella about how Bush League her little castle is? Anyway, Sir Lady-in-Waiting Night Elf said that we probably couldn't shoot because we were an independent, self-financed film. Apparently the Queen is still a little ticked off about that whole independence thing. So because we weren't of, by, for, whatever, the BBC or any other big company, and had no distribution, which is why you might not even be watching this movie, we couldn't shoot the music lesson over there in Buckingham Palace. But we did get a copy of the music lesson, which we can show whenever we want. See? Right here. And we licensed this from Film Art LA, which is in the United States and doesn't care that we're independent. But we don't need the real Vermeer because Tim is going to paint his own and wait until the Queen wants to see his.
The contents of this drawer have evolved over these months. And there's not much in here that I don't use.
The most useful tool is the palette knife.
I use a lot of these little smudge sticks to wipe up paint. That's not what they were designed for, but they work well for that. Brush to clean. I'm going back and forth between three pairs of glasses constantly. These glasses are general purpose. I can focus those down to about 10 inches. 3.5 diopter reading glasses, and then I think these are 4.5 or 5 diopter. That way I can get right down, I can see this close.
What else have I got?
Occasionally I use this protractor, tape measure, black masking tape, very handy, C-clamp, as well as a spring clamp. I also have surgical tweezers. I have these giant eyebrows, and they fall into the paint sometimes. A glass full of cotton swabs, and a Sharpie. And here's something I don't actually use. Sandpaper to sharpen my smudge sticks.
What else have I got in here?
Piece of aluminum with tongue depressors on it. Pencils. Pencil sharpener. Silly putty. And 8 pinball machines.